बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। आई एम मोहम्मद आबुल हुसैन सरकार, असिस्टेंट हेडमास्टर भवेरचर वजर अली हाई स्कूल, गजारिया, मुंशीगंज। डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी वेल एंड गुड बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ ऑलमाइटी अल्लाह। अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, आई एम ऑल्सो फाइन। डियर लर्नर्स एंड व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ भवेरचर वजर अली हाई स्कूल। आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट यू फॉर जॉइनिंग द ऑनलाइन क्लास विथ डीप अटेंशन एंड अवेयरनेस। डियर लर्नर्स एंड व्यूअर्स, माय हार्टी वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज कंप्लीटिंग सेंटेंसेस पार्ट 3। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द प्रीवियस क्लास आई डिस्कस्ड 10 रूल्स of completing sentence. Today I will discuss another 5 rules of completing sentence. Let us start rule 11. E plus present plus future. Look at the whiteboard. E plus conditional, rule 11. E plus present plus future. According to structure, we have to learn E clause present indefinite tense. The principal clause will be future indefinite tense. For example, if you come dash, if you come, this is an incomplete sentence. This is subordinate clause or if clause. If clause is present indefinite tense, the principal clause will be future indefinite tense. If you come, I shall go. Here I shall go, this is future indefinite tense. Next example, if you play in the rain, dash. Dear learners and viewers, if you play in the rain, this is an incomplete sentence. This is subordinate clause or if clause. We have to use a principal clause with it. If the subordinate clause is present indefinite tense, the principal clause will be future indefinite tense. If you play in the rain, you will catch cold. You will catch cold. Dear learners and viewers, you will catch cold, this is future indefinite tense. Rule 12. E plus past indefinite tense plus past conditional. Subject plus would oblique could oblique might plus v1 plus dot dot. Dear learners and viewers, rule 12, E plus past indefinite tense plus past conditional. Here past conditional means subject plus would oblique could oblique might plus be one plus dot dot. Here be one means present form of verb, base form of verb. Example, if he came dash I would go. If he came, this is subordinate clause or if clause. I would go, this is principal clause. According to structure, if plus past indefinite, he came, this is past indefinite tense, plus past conditional means subject I, would oblique could oblique might, plus would plus be one, present form of verb or base form of verb, go. If he came, I would go. Next example, if I got a visa dash, if I got a visa, if conditional, this is subordinate clause, if clause, here past indefinite tense plus past conditional, subject plus would oblique, could oblique, might plus be one, base form of verb plus extension. If I got a visa, I would go to America. Dear learners, here if clause is past indefinite tense and principal clause is past conditional, subject that is I, would oblique could oblique might would plus be one, base form of verb that is go plus extension to America. If I got a visa, I would go to America. Rule 13, E plus past perfect plus perfect conditional. Perfect conditional, subject plus would have oblique could have oblique might have oblique plus past participle form of verb orthat B3. Dear learners and viewers, rule 13, E plus past perfect plus perfect conditional. Perfect conditional means subject plus would have oblique could have oblique might have plus past participle form is verb, that is B3. Example, if I had seen him dash if clause this is subordinate clause the principal clause will be perfect conditional according to structure perfect conditional means subject here subject I would have oblique might have would have plus past participle form of verb that is be3 I would have told other word him the news dear learners if I had seen him I would have told him the news according to structure perfect conditional means subject I would have could have might have would have plus past participle form of verb that is be3 told plus extension if I had seen him I would have told him the news the next one if they had started earlier dash if they had started earlier this is if clause or subordinate clause the principal clause will be perfect conditional if they had started earlier perfect conditional principal clause will be perfect conditional subject if they had started earlier they could have got the train in time dear learners and viewers if clause this is past perfect tense if they had started earlier if subordinate clause is past perfect tense the principal clause will be perfect conditional means subject here subject they would have could have might have after they we have used could have plus past participle form of verb that is be3 got plus extension if they had started earlier they could have got the train in time Rule 14 if plus subject plus where plus past conditional dear learners and viewers I have written on the whiteboard if plus subject plus where plus past conditional here if clause will be past indefinite tense plus principal clause will be past conditional we know past conditional means subject plus would oblique might plus base form of verb that is be1 example if I were a king if I were a king, this is subordinate clause or if clause. If plus subject plus were plus other word plus past conditional. Past conditional means subject plus would oblique could oblique might plus base form of verb or means be one. If I were a king, I would help the poor. I would help the poor. This is principal clause. I would help the poor, dear learners. Past conditional, subject would oblique could oblique might plus base form or verb. Here base form help plus extension. If I were a king, I would help the poor. The next one, if I were you, dash. This is if clause or subordinate clause. The principal clause will be past conditional. If I were you, I would not do this. Dear learners, if clause or subordinate clause, past indefinite tense. Here principal clause, past conditional, this is also past indefinite tense. Past conditional means subject would oblique could oblique might plus base form plus extension. Here this sentence is negative. This is why we have used here after would, we have used here not. If I were you, I would not do this. Rule 15. Head plus subject plus past participle form of verb, that is B3 plus extension. Dear learners and viewers, look at the structure: head plus subject plus past participle form of verb, that is B3 plus extension. Had I seen him, dash. Here, had I seen him, this is subordinate clause. The principal clause will be perfect conditional. Past participle form, here according to structure sub head plus subject I plus past participle, that is seen, plus dot dot. The principal clause will be perfect conditional. Perfect conditional means subject plus would have oblique could have oblique might have plus past participle form of verb B3. Had I seen him, I would have given him the news. Dear learners and viewers, according to structure head plus subject I plus past participle form of verb, that is seen, plus other word him. The principal clause will be perfect conditional. Perfect conditional means subject, that is I, plus would have, oblique would have, oblique might have. After subject, we have used would have, plus B3, past participle form of verb, that is given, plus extension. Next example, had I possessed a vast property, dash. Dear learners and viewers, had I possessed a vast property, this is subordinate clause. We have to add a principal clause with it. The principal clause will be perfect conditional. Had I possessed a vast property, I could have established a college. Dear learners and viewers, had I possessed a vast property, this is subordinate clause. We have to join a principal clause with it. I have written a principal clause with it. I could have established a college. The principal clause will be perfect conditional. Here subject I, would have, oblique could have, oblique might have. We have used here could have. Then we have used B3, past participle form of verb established. Past participle form of verb established plus extension. Had I possessed a vast property, I could have established a college. Dear learners and students, I discussed 5 rules of today's class. Now I am going to finish my class. Dear students and learners, stay home, stay safe. Thank you everybody very much. Goodbye. See you in the next class.